Think of any different language through their eyes. We know that they cannot smile like us. They cannot speak any language like us, but every sound they produce has meaning. Don't you have pets? Have you ever thought of having a panda as your pet? Never, because pandas are not very commonly seen in Kerala, right? This lesson number 4, we study about pandas. Pandas belong to the bear family. There are 8 types of bears in India, in the world. Pandas are black and white bears. They look very cuddly, it seems. The female pandas are called sows, male pandas are called bars, and the baby pandas are called cubs. The panda is a symbol of peace in China. The Chinese regard them as a symbol of peace. What do you think is the symbol of peace? Yes, sometimes we fly pigeon as a symbol of peace. Sometimes we wave the white flag as a symbol of peace. But Chinese think pandas as the symbol of peace. Pandas are black and white bears. They have huge body, huge head. Their ears are round and their tails are so short. Even though their body and head are huge, they climb the trees easily. Chinese call the pandas giant cat bear. You know why? The pandas can see very well even during night. They have good eyesight, very sharp eyesight like cats. That is why Chinese call pandas giant cat bear. Giant pandas are mainly black and white. However, the black patches around eyes, ears, shoulders, chest and legs and feet also, they have black marks, black patches. Zebra also has black and white design on their body. Only in that color you can find them. But they are like stripes. Pandas have black color here and there only. Throughout their body it is white in color, but around their eyes it is black. Around their ears it is black, on chest and near the paws it is black in color. So what do Chinese call them? Giant cat bear. Why? Because they have very sharp eyesight like cat. Where do pandas live? Any idea? Do they live on the trees as I told you, like monkeys? No. They live in the rocky, snowy places. Their black and white color combination will help them to escape from enemies. Some huge animals like snow leopard and all can kill them and eat them. But their color combination, black and white color, no, it will help them to hide in the snow, so that they can escape from their enemies. They have huge body, huge head and very short tail and round ears also. You just imagine they have soft and thick hair on their body. Not like a bear, more than the bear, they have very thick hair on their body. They are very soft. That is why we feel cuddly too. When we see the pandas, we feel cuddly. Cuddly in the sense, we feel like fondling them. We like to fondle our pets, right? Same way, we feel like fondling them. Hug them. The meaning is cuddly. Meaning is creating a feel to hug someone. To fondle someone. The pandas also have a very thick oily fur, so that they can escape from the rough weather also. We know in the snow it is very difficult to survive, but it is very easy for the bears and pandas to live in the snow because they have woolly, oily and thick hair. This helps them to live happily and smoothly in the snow. Now, how do pandas sleep? Pandas sleep on the top of the trees using their claws. Claws means the fist, this part. Using their claws, they hold tightly on the branches of the trees and sleep on the very top of the trees without any fear. Pandas grow like a tall person. The biggest panda will be like a very tall person and like 6 feet tall, and height will be 6 feet tall, the biggest panda. And the weight also will be equal to a very tall man. Now let us see how do they move. You know, pandas cannot move on their hind legs. They cannot walk like human beings, but bears can. Pandas belong to the bear family, but they cannot walk like bears on their hind legs. Bears can walk like human beings on their hind legs, behind, backside, the back legs. Animals normally use their hands also to touch on the floor to walk, so that it seems that they have four legs, right? But some animals can use their back legs. These are called hind legs. Like bears, they can even walk like a human being, but pandas cannot. Now let us see what do pandas eat. They normally in forest, if they live on their own surroundings, their own place in the forest, they eat bamboos, bamboo sprouts, bamboo leaves. It's their most favorite food. But nowadays in the forest, there are not enough bamboo forests. As a result, they go starving. But you know, when they are caught and tamed and protected in the sanctuaries, wildlife sanctuaries, they eat cereal, oranges, apples and bamboo sprouts also, and different type of leaves and vegetables also they eat. You know, they need lots of food every day. 10 to 20 kilograms of food every day is needed for them. You know, one thing that the bamboo forests are getting lesser and lesser in our forest. As a result, pandas are getting fewer and fewer in numbers. They are getting extincted. They are getting extinct. Extinct in the sense, getting fewer and fewer in number. In very short years, we will not be able to find any pandas in the world. There are only 1,000 pandas left in the world, it seems. That means all of a sudden on a day they may get disappeared from the earth. The only reason is the greed of the human being to cut the forests, destroy the bamboo forests, and it causes starvation for pandas. And they may not be able to survive if there is no food. So we have to be taken care. Bamboo forests are found in Wayanad, then Periyar at Thekkady. Very, very few places only we can find bamboo forests. Pandas are taken care of in many wildlife sanctuaries in the world. In India, we have Padmaja Naidu Zoological Park in West Bengal. This wildlife sanctuary takes care of pandas. So that, let us hope there will be more number of pandas in the world, in India. Unlike other animals, pandas have a thumb on their paw. Normally, animals on their paws are very short, fingers are not separated. But you know, For pandas, a special wrist bone is an extra growth of the wrist bone. It works like a thumb for them so that they can hold the bamboo sprouts and eat. So let me stop the lesson here today. Learn the meanings of the words which are bolded. Learn, read the textbook very well. Be answerable in the class. I will ask you certain questions about the lesson in the class. Be ready to be answerable. Be ready and answerable. Yes, there ends our today's lesson. Take care.